If you're here, you've not been fasting. I want to advise you that it's yours to your Christian life.
Amen.
If you're here and you don't have any personal fasted life, sometimes when I talk to somebody, I mean, it's like partially on a 14 days fast. But when I hear things like this, it's exciting.
Amen.
They want to hear, the way people are smiling, it's like you don't like fasting. Well, I know food is sweet, but the Bible says in Romans chapter 14, verse 17, the kingdom of God is not in eating and drinking, but in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Matthew chapter 6, he said that, if you read Matthew chapter 6, verse 24 downwards, he was saying that the reason why many people worry is because of what to eat and what to wear. He says, take no thought for yourself. Your Heavenly Father already knows. 1 Timothy chapter 6. It says, having food and raiment, let us be content. So you realize that based on these two scriptures, reason, the basic necessity of man is what to eat and what to wear. And the Bible says, if you have these two, you should be content in life. These are the basic. It doesn't mean you shouldn't strive. The reason for contentment is to severe and protect you from greed. It's not for you to have, because when you read that same 1 Timothy chapter 6, you realize that many people fell out of faith because of their greed. And so when Paul was advising Timothy, he told him that, abstain from these errors of these people. He said, abstain from them, drop them, and they would follow and pursue after righteousness, after godliness, after justice. He gave many examples of things Paul is supposed to pursue after. So realize that you need God, and that's why you don't have to deal with your prayer life. No, I went to my brother was like, I mean, I have a problem. It was interesting. I said, oh, don't worry, come to church, okay? You know what you do? And he was laughing. I mean, it's that you're a politician. He was thinking that he wants quick fix, right? People of God, I'm not the kind of pastor. I'm like, blessings, okay? Blessings are good, but I'm more interested in training you. I'm more interested in giving you the word of God that can train you for you to be able to live for God all by yourself. Not always coming to the pastor. That is the goal of a minister, to equip you to do the work of ministry. That's what Ephesians chapter 4, verse 14 was saying, 11 to 14. To equip you to do the work of the ministry. That means that I am the coach, you people are the players. And if you look at it there, when a tournament is won, it is the players who hold the trophy and they rejoice. Usually the coach is somewhere at the back. It is only when the players remember that coach, they'll come and carry the coach. So what I'm interested in doing is to have many passions in life. One of them is to see all of you work in the purpose of God for your life. If at least if I'm able to accomplish that, I'll be satisfied. Not baby feed you or spoon feed you always.
Okay, sorry.
No, yeah, oh my God, YouTube, so I'll have to be very careful. So not to spoon feed you or baby. Feed you, babysit you always. Okay? So, that's why if you want to go far in your life, then I'm your friend. Because I don't like average life. No. I'll push you. If you don't like somebody to push you in life, then don't be afraid. Yeah. That's why I have this spirit of not always being satisfied. Because I want to know. If you don't have that spirit, you will always plateau at one place. But in the kingdom of God, we never arrive. And that's why you always have to keep moving. You remember Apostle Paul? Upon all the credentials, he says that, I forget all of these things, I consider them as done, and what I press towards the mark. There is a goal for all of us. Until we have gotten the trophy, we have no right to say we have arrived. So, if you want mama come to hear the word of God, don't forget, Bible says judgment shall start from the house of the Lord. So, you know that when rapture happens, not everybody in jail will make it, right? By now, you should know that. So, take your Christian life serious. Don't be just concerned about coming to church. Take God very serious. Take God very serious. Have a Christian life even without church. Because the time is coming when the persecution... Maybe one of these days, I'll teach you about the coming civilization of heaven in this way. And you realize that when I do that teaching, I pray that when I read that teaching, our eyes will really be open. Our eyes will really be open. In this time where we find ourselves, passive Christianity is not allowed. God, the Bible teaches us, says you always have to be ablaze in passion. Be your zeal. Anytime you realize that your zeal for God is draining, find a way to get back, because it's not normal for a Christian.
God expects us to be on fire for Him always. Passion for God should be there always. So if you realize that all these things are going down, quickly find help from God. If you are finding a problem, maybe if you can open up to me, talk to your brother or sister you believe can help you. Put personal reputation aside. There's prosperity and the salvation of your soul is more important than your reputation. Nobody goes to heaven with reputation. Philippians chapter 2 verse 5. Even Jesus made himself of no reputation.